Welcome back to my channel. I'm Julie here at Broche Ballet, where we help adults become the dancer of their dreams at any age. Today, I'm going to talk a little bit about ballet slippers. I'm going to talk about how they should fit, what to do with drawstrings, and a little bit more about some common questions that I get about ballet slippers. Before we get started, if you haven't already heard the news, we are having our very first in-person ballet festival and intensive next summer in 2022 here in Miami. So if you've been dreaming of the stage or have a particular variation that you'd love to perform, consider joining us here in Miami at the International Adult Ballet Festival, the first annual like its kind to give adult dancers a place to be taken seriously, perform their work on stage. All levels are welcome. All dancers are worthy of the stage. For basic information about ballet slippers, go check out my first YouTube video on the topic. This one I'm getting into a little bit more specifics, the things that people ask me generally after watching that video. Now, ballet slippers are such an important part of our journey, and so it's important to make sure that they fit you properly. So when a pair of ballet slippers arrive, we have a couple different kinds that you might get. We have leather ballet slippers, we have canvas ballet slippers, and stretch canvas. So leather ballet slippers, I like to wear these. They're Capizio Juliet, and they're a pretty thin leather. They're not too thick of a leather. They're a split sole. Personally, I like split sole better than full sole because it's a little easier to feel my feet and feel the floor. Some schools like you to have full sole in the beginning. It gives you a little bit more resistance in your feet when you're pointing. But I find personally that feeling the floor underneath my feet is a little bit more valuable than this full sole. But the leather slipper, these are a pretty thin leather. Sometimes leather can feel a little bit bulky around your feet. These are pretty thin leather. So we got leather slippers. They tend to last pretty long, although I teach about 25 hours live and you can see I already burned through where that big toe is. Imagine if it was a canvas pair. So we have canvas. These are a thicker material. Canvas doesn't have much give to it. So plain canvas is really, really nice and gives you good support around your feet. And then we have the new trend, which is stretch canvas. So it's like canvas, but it's stretchy. It feels almost like a sock on your foot. So us adult dancers, we have different needs when it comes to our feet than a lot of child dancers. So we need a little bit more support under the arches. Maybe we have a little sensitivity under the foot and we want a little bit more padding. So let's talk about some of those little details about your ballet slipper that can make it more or less comfortable. Personally, if you find that you want more support in your slipper, I do not recommend a stretch canvas slipper. This is gonna feel just like a sock and give you very little support. I would recommend either leather or a canvas slipper that has a pretty thick pad here under the ball of the foot. Especially there, it can feel really comfortable and cushy if you have a nice pad. These are a Nicolet Tempo, also the Grishko Mod 6 if you're out of the US. They have a really nice pad under the ball of the foot to keep your foot nice and comfortable when you're standing for long periods of time. The only thing to note is that they don't come with the front of the elastic sewn on. You have to do just a little stitch on the front of your shoe to sew that on yourself. You can do it with a machine or needle and thread. But other than that, they have really, really nice padding under the foot to give you nice support. Sometimes on releve, it can be painful under your foot and that can be really helpful. Now, if you find that you need a lot of arch support or you're new on your ballet journey, you might consider, especially if you're practicing at home, a jazz sneaker. So the great thing about the jazz sneaker is that they're flexible, so you can point your feet really nicely, but they're also slippery on the bottom so they can slide across the floor and you're not going to have any issue with things like tendu. And you can see how thick the padding is under here. It can give you a really nice cushion on the floor if you find that the floor is really unforgiving for your feet. These can be really nice for you. With the jazz sneaker, you do want to work up to a ballet slipper, and some studios are going to want you to wear a ballet slipper and not a jazz sneaker, but they're a really, really great place to start if you are feeling like you need more support and pulling you up away from the floor. There's two more options if you need more support under your feet. There's what's called a t-shirt shoe, which is a really cute, almost like a Mary Jane style for ladies that has a small heel underneath it. So that can be really nice for giving you more support under the feet, especially if you experience plantar fasciitis underneath your feet. Some studios might let you wear those in class. And second, there is a really awesome brand, check the description below, that does offer a little bit of support, arch support built in underneath the slipper that is really helpful for some dancers to feel more support under their feet. How should a ballet slipper fit? I'm gonna show you my canvas slipper. So as I put my canvas slipper on, this one is a little bit too big. I accidentally ordered a half size up, but it's great because I can show you why they're a little bit too big for me. So as I put this slipper on, there is quite a bit of room around the side of the slipper. It pulls really far away from me. Even though I pulled this drawstring really tight, there's a lot of space. There's also a lot of fabric around here that's really, really bulky. You can also see as I have my toes moving around that there's a lot of movement, there's a lot of fabric here around the toe that I can kind of pull away. When I stand up to demi point, there's a lot of gapping here. Again, even though I've pulled the drawstring tight, there's a lot of gapping here and it's just a little bit too big for my feet. You want your shoe to be a little bit more snug on your foot than this, not be able to pull the fabric away, because you want that when you turn and you do things that your feet don't feel like they're sliding within the shoe. You want the shoe to be hugging your foot. Now, if it's too small, you're gonna get this knuckling and it's gonna feel like you're jamming against your toenails and it's gonna pull your toes up. Now that's gonna be super painful. We also don't want it to be too small. So we wanna make sure we get a good fit there, not too big that you feel like you're swimming in it and you can really pull the fabric away, and not too small that you feel like your toes are jamming and having to get bent up as you go on to releve. Now this same slipper, I painted it red for a Nutcracker class that we did online on Zoom last Christmas, but the same exact slipper in red, in the correct size, is a lot sleeker on my foot. You can see that I can't pinch as much fabric away, I don't have as much space here, and when I go up on releve, there's not as much gapping around the side of the slipper. So this one hugs my foot a lot more nicely and is a much better size. Now my stretch canvas slippers, these you wanna fit pretty snug, especially because they do stretch. So you want them to fit pretty snug around your foot. You still wanna be able to move your toes, but they are pretty snug, pretty tight, like a sock, really hugging your foot. On releve, you can see it sitting right around my foot. The heel is nice and close and connected. Now again, these are really close to the floor. You can really feel the floor right under your foot. Every little bit of dirt and crack in the floor you can feel with a stretch canvas slipper. You really don't want these to be too big. If they're baggy, your feet are gonna be moving and swimming around in them so much. And then for my leather slippers, I do like to wear, if I'm not wearing full-footed tights, I like to wear a little sock. These are what you would just wear in your flats, in your flat shoes. Men tend to wear actual athletic socks underneath their slippers, but I personally prefer to wear these little socks that you get from Amazon or anywhere you're gonna get things for your dress shoes. I like to wear a little sock under my leather slippers, so I'll put that on first. I happen to have just bought these. They just came, as you can see. My old ones are just about done, so I can show you how they fit new and fresh. So as I put it on, these come pre-sewn. Some, again, don't come pre-sewn, but these do. I put them on, and then what we're gonna see, oops, the drawstring's a little too tight. As we put the shoe on, we can see that the leather fits pretty snug. Now, leather does stretch over time, and what I'm gonna show you is a shoe that is a pretty snug shoe. Now, with the leather, this is a little bit close to too tight. It's just a little bit close to too tight. I happen to know that this pair of slippers stretches quite a bit over time, but it is pretty tight. You can see my toe is right at the edge of the shoe, but it has a good hug around my foot and I can't pull anywhere. The telltale sign that it's okay is as I go up, I don't feel that my toes will curl. In your releve, you want your toes to be flat and not bunched up. So if you feel that the shoe is causing you to bunch up, then it's too tight. Now with these drawstrings, you can see there's a little gapping. When I'm on demi point, don't do this on flat, I like to do on demi point, give a little tug to the drawstring, place the foot down, and then do a little tie. Just one overhand to start, and then back up on demi, check for gapping. If there's gapping, pull a little tighter, but make sure the toes don't claw as you go. Once you're happy with the drawstring, then tie another, like a double knot here, tie across, then you can snip the ends with the scissors and tuck those drawstrings into your shoes. Now, some ballet slippers have a single elastic across the center. That's also perfectly fine. As I mentioned, the leather slippers do stretch a good amount. Now here is my new slipper and here is my old slipper. So there's quite a big difference in how they fit, how much room I have to pull a finger versus the new one. There's not much space. You can see around my toes, there's a little bit of material here. However, on this shoe, there's not a lot of material. This is the new shoe, and this is how much they stretch for the old shoe over a period of time. So they do have quite a bit of give to them. Canvas almost stretches almost not at all, and stretch canvas doesn't really stretch a ton either. It kind of keeps its shape. It does stretch a little bit, but not a lot. The leather stretches quite a bit and doesn't pull back in. For sizing of your ballet slippers, for the most part, each brand is going to have a street shoe to ballet slipper size. They should have information on if they run true to size or not. So just experiment with a little bit of sizing. Make sure you check the return policy so you can try a few if you don't have access to a store to go and try them on in person and see how they work on your feet. If you do have different size feet, great news, they don't actually come with left or right. You mold them to your feet. So for example, my old shoe, this is my left foot because that's where my big toe is, that tends to wear through the shoe. But when they came, they were the same. So you could potentially buy two different pairs of ballet slippers, one in one size, one in the other, wear one from each, and then when those wear out, wear the other pair from each. So you can buy two pairs, and then you can wear both pairs. You don't waste any shoe from those pairs. You can wear them once the other wears out. All right, dancers, I hope this quick little video was really helpful for you to think about how your shoes should fit, whether you're thinking about leather, canvas, stretched canvas, or if you need more support under your feet, between your feet and the floor. Let me know if you have questions or additional tips for your fellow adult dancers in the comments below, and I'll hopefully see you in Miami next summer. Until next time, happy dancing.